right, from Cyclone Stadium, welcome to tonight's broadcast of the regular season finale as the Eastern View Cyclones play host to the Chancellor Chargers. Hello, everyone. I'm Mark O'Connell alongside Steve Peacock. See, where it's only appropriate that I say that it's cold and windy here at Cyclone Stadium. We're in this, where we're known to feel the wind many times throughout the broadcast, literally and figuratively, but more literally tonight maybe than anything else. How does it feel to be here knowing that this is a regular season finale and each of you comes in with a couple blows? One they lost last week, the first time in a long time, and they lost Chance Graves in their lineup as well.
Yeah, they did, Mark. It's so cold, and I got tears to my eyes. It's cold out here. I'm really feeling the wind tonight. You're right. They come in a little bruised, a little battered, not battered, but a little bruised. They lost to Chance, Spotsylvania last week. First time since October 21st, 2015, against Sherando, regular season game. I think it was a good loss for them, Mark. They learned a lot of things last week. They had a lot of penalties, turnovers. I mean, Spotsylvania came down, scored the first three times they handled the ball. Then Eastern View shut them out the rest of the way, but they just couldn't put it in the end zone. Had, like I said, turnovers and penalties killed them. So they worked on it, had a good week of practice. I think they're ready to go. They know what they got to do in the playoffs. They'll probably end up going to be, they win tonight, they're going to be a third seed. And more than likely, we'll have a first-round game against Dinwiddie or possibly Patrick Henry of Ashland, where Coach Ken Wakefield is the head coach. He's Coach Culpeper. So I think tonight what they got to do is they got to take care of business tonight. Last regular season game, senior night for the seniors as well. And I think you're going to see a rejuvenated well-disciplined Eastern View team tonight.
So, as you pointed out, last week may have been a good loss. Came at not a bad time. Certainly a worst time in the year to lose could be possible, but last week may have been a wake-up call for them. And nothing lasts forever, including winning streaks. I'm not sure in the scheme of things that's really that important. It's something nice for people to talk about and for the record books, but let's face it, the bigger prize is always what happens in the postseason. So tell the viewing audience tonight, win or lose, where is this going to leave Eastern View as they look ahead after tonight's game to the postseason?
Well, it's going to leave and win. They're going to be a third seed. Lose, they could possibly fall down to a five, possibly. It depends on all the, you know, what goes on in other games throughout the region tonight. But I don't look for Eastern View to lose. Chancellor's an improved team. They've got a lot to play for, especially tonight. They've got a win to get in. They're battling King George, who happens to be playing Spotsylvania tonight. So one of those two teams is going to get in. If both win, possibly both of them get in, but one of them's going to. So it's going to be Eastern View's going to have their hands full tonight. They're going to have to play sound football, but I think if they do that, they'll win tonight.
One final question for you, Steve. How big of a loss is it to Eastern View to lose Chance Graves? Because we've seen him excel on not only both sides of the football, but also in special teams. To what extent is that a big blow to this team?
It's a blow, Mark, but as Greg Hadfield always said, Coach Hadfield, next man up. I think they got enough athletes to cover that up. He hurts them more being on defense, losing them from a defensive standpoint, than they do offense. I mean, he was a good receiver, but very valued in the defensive secondary. And then you're going to have Ronte Robinson is going to be banged up. Look for him not to have action tonight either. So they come in a little banged up. But again, I think the next man up, I think Coach Hadfield and the staff will probably come up with a good game plan to cover that up.
Well, what about the fact that Drew Sharina had 112 rushing yards last week? I didn't see that coming.
No, I didn't either, so that's just another added weapon.
All right. Well, listen, looking forward to calling the game with you tonight. Again, it's cold and windy here at Cyclone Stadium, and this is the regular season finale as Eastern View is playing host to Chancellor. So we know Eastern View is destined for the playoffs. Chancellor, as Steve pointed out, is vying for a playoff spot. They've got a lot of incentive here tonight. We expect a good game. I expect each of you to come out on top when it's all said and done. But we're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll have team captain center of the field for tonight's coin toss. Stay tuned. You're watching Cyclones Football on the Culpeper Media Network.
Not everyone is an HVAC expert, Luckily, with 20 years of experience, Able Heating and Air can answer any and all questions you may have about your system. Peace of mind and knowledge that you've made the right choice, because they are able to keep your home comfortable. Able Heating and Air.
Battlefield Automotive is proud to continue support of our high school youth and the Culpeper community. Winner of the prestigious Ford President's Award for a record 13 consecutive years. Battlefield Automotive, a keystone of service and a cornerstone of our community.
CFC Farm and Home Center, hometown service since 1932. Finding the right outerwear for the job is difficult. Luckily, you'll find Carhartt clothing, Red Wing, and Irish Center boots. From head to toe, it's easy to outfit with CFC Farm and Home Center. Found in Sons Funeral Chapels has made it their business to provide solutions during difficult times for over a quarter of a century. During that time, they've also made an investment in our youth through football, basketball, softball, baseball, lacrosse, and 4-H, among other projects. Good luck to tonight's teams, and do your best. Mama May's Pizza and Subs at our new location on 620 Sperryville Pike still serves you the best in pizza, subs, salads, and so much more. Always fresh, always good, only Mama May's. UVA Community Credit Union is a not-for-profit financial cooperative owned by individual members like you. Your financial success enables us to offer better products and services to all of our members and to be a positive force in the Culpeper community.
All right, from Cyclone Stadium, welcome to tonight's broadcast of high school football as Eastern Butte plays host to the visiting Chancellor Chargers. I'm Mark O'Connell alongside Steve Peacock and Johnny Krawchuk behind the camera tonight up top, where it's going to be really cold, really windy, and we're going to try to be a little bit warmer in this press box. Steve, let's talk about tonight's matchup. You're looking at the team captains right now for both teams. Cyclones with the black helmets, black pants, blue jerseys, black numbers. Chancellor Chargers, team colors maroon and gray and white. And Chancellor comes in at 5-4, Eastern View at 8-1. Both teams, we know Eastern View is going to make the playoffs. Chancellor's vying for a playoff spot as well, so they've got a lot of incentive. What do you expect tonight in this matchup?
Well, Mark, as we look at the captains right there, Blake Leake, Drew Sherina, Till Butler, and Garrett Hutchinson out there. What I expect tonight is for a rejuvenated Eastern Butte team to come out fired up and want to really, you know, play hard and put away this Chancellor team early if they can, so they get ready for the playoffs. Chancellor's fighting for a playoff spot. They're riding a little bit of a winning streak coming in here. Their all go-to player is their quarterback, and he's going to be the one, Trayvon Edwards, that they're going to have to keep an eye on. And he can throw it, and he can run it. So they're going to have to watch him. And if they can keep him in check, they can do a pretty good. They can come out pretty good in this game, I think.
All right, Chancellor won the toss and deferred. So Eastern View's choice is that it will receive. So we're going to see the Eastern View offense initially tonight, unless, of course, the special teams returns one for a touchdown. And I'll say this, the special teams will be playing without the services of Chance Graves, as will the defensive and offensive units, because he's out with a knee injury. And we've talked about that, Steve, and you know, when I asked you about that, to what extent that's a blow for Eastern View, you said, well, it's like Coach Hatfield says, when one guy goes down, it's the next man up mentality. So someone's going to have to step up in his place, and that's been one of the hallmarks of this Eastern View team to do just that. So that being said, Eastern View comes in tonight with a record of 8-1. Chancellor's 5-4. Eastern View last week lost to Spotsylvania. The Knights ended the Cyclones' 44-game regular season win streak. And meanwhile, Chancellor was playing James Monroe and lost 27-13. And as Steve pointed out, their main guy is Trevin Edwards. This is an interesting lineup or formation for this kickoff team with Chancellor, as the kicker is Baylor Gallagher. They go back to the conventional lineup here, and here's Gallagher's left-footed kick, end over end. And it looks like Spangler gets under it at about the 10-yard line. He's crossed the 20, picks up a block, comes to the near side, 25, 30, breaks the tackle, 35. Still on his feet, 40, 45, crosses midfield. If he can just break this one tackle, he might go all the way. Instead, they're going to say he's down about the 45-yard line. I didn't actually see him go down, Steve, but what a nice return from about I'll say about the 10-yard line out to the 45 on the Chancellor side of the football field. Special teams give the team a big lift here to start things.
That was all Alex Spangler, Mark, right there in that kickoff here. He looted, he started out to the left, broke it back to the right, had a wall a little set up, and he looked like he was going to be closed out of the sideline about the 30, 35-yard line, but he broke about four tackles, and like I said, his knee touched. That's why they blew it down.
All right, so here is Till Butler and the Eastern View offensive unit starting in excellent field position. And they hand it off to the running back there. I believe this was Rock Lawson, who lost his footing shy of the 40-yard line.
Yeah, Rock Lawson just came in and just, you know, just kind of tried to make a cut, lost his footing there. We had some rain this week earlier and the other day, and it's made this field a little bit soft, a little bit wet.
So Till Butler sends three receivers to the left. Rock Lawson on his left in the backfield on second down and seven. Chancellor shows pressure. They hand off, and they immediately wrap up Lawson near the line of scrimmage. Several Chargers in on the tackle, including big number 76. And that was Andrew Nickens. So it brings up third down and seven. And this opening drive for Eastern Group. And now we've got daylight. All right, so third down play here. Till Butler back there with Rock Lawson. He sends two receivers to the left. One bottoming his screen there. On a third and seven. Here's Butler's first throw. It's caught near the 35-yard line. And it's, let's check the spot. I believe it's going to be a little shy of a first down. That was Spangler on the reception.
Yeah, they're going to say about a yard and a half short. Now what do you do? You used to view, go for it here. You're deep in your own into the territory. Punt's not going to help you very much right here, Mark.
I think you probably go for it. It's at the 39. And I'm going to call it fourth and about one at the 33-yard line, rather. Fourth down in a yard. They do line up to go for it. Till Butler, the quarterback, in the gun. Lawson on his left. They're going to try to draw the Chancellor defense offside. Butler's going to keep it straight ahead. He goes, and his forward effort should give him enough for a first down. That should move the sticks.
That was just a great call. Good call, Mark. Right there, just giving you quarterback, getting the quarterback sneak. Basically getting, you know, your quarterback to pick up that yard and a half and, you know, keep the chains moving. And so he's just getting a new set of downs.
Off the 31-yard line, first and 10. Cyclones just under 10 minutes to play here in this first quarter. This is the opening drive. Blake Leak goes top of your screen. Josh Logan in the slot there on the left. Two receivers to the right as well, as Butler is going to hand off to Drew Sharina, his first carry of the night. And Sharina got inside the 30 and to the 28-yard line for a gain of about 3 yards. Second and seven coming up here.
And Mark, it looks like that Eli Harris is going to be replacing Chance Graves at that wide receiver spot on the outside. And like I say, you don't really get a, you know, he's a junior defensive back and wide receiver, 5'8", 160 pounds.
And here, Sharina got 4 yards. It's second and six. Two receivers to the left, one to the right. That's Butler in the gun. Sharina on his left, Rock Lawson on his right. Sharina the lead blocker for Lawson. Going to try to get to the outside here. And Chancellor does a pretty good job of stopping him near the 25-yard line. Several Chargers in on the tackle there, including number 13, Braden Druggetts.
He's the coach's son.
Mm-hmm. And the coach, as you pointed out. Well, I've got Brian Wetzel as the head coach.
Jeff Druggetts is the coach for Chancellor.
Is that what's on that roster?
Yeah, I mean, Drew Gatz, I mean, that's what.
Max Preps has Brian Wetzel as the head coach. We'll check that for clarification. In any event, it's third and three right here from the 25-yard line. This is Sharina, it looks like. That's Mikey Keene, rather. And he got behind the block of big number 70, Jason Southern, and enough for another Cyclone first down. So the Cyclones have had the ball here almost 4 minutes. They started with excellent field position at the Chargers 43. Now they have two first downs to their credit, and they now have it first and 10 from the Chargers 20-yard line. That is Mikey Keene alongside Till Butler there in the gun. Long snap count. Looks like Butler trying to draw him off sides. Doesn't work. Looks to the sidelines for further instructions.
And, you know, Mikey Keene brings that big package, big running back, into the game.
And they fake it to Keene. Here's Butler on the keeper. Breaks a tackle, and then he's wrapped up by big number 55 of Chancellor. And that is Adam Smith with the initial hit.
Butler on the keeper.
And that brings up second down. What brings up a second and six? What has Eastern View got in their playbook here, Mark?
Well, they got a couple opportunities here, and with the weapons they have, I would think they have quite a bit of options. They're going to go in this backfield with Rock Lawson on the right of Butler and Sharina on his left. Sharina gets the call. Here's Sharina straight ahead. Good running down to about the 10-yard line, and that should be it'll be very close to a first down. It may be a first down. All right, so they mark it at the 10. That'll be first and goal from that spot. And we are just under the 7-minute mark, and this is a drive that Eastern View began on Chancellor's 43-yard line. They now have it at the 10. We got movement left side, and that's going to bring in our first penalty flag of the night. And on the left side for Eastern View, that's Elijah Hoskins, who may be the guilty party.
Yeah, these are things that Eastern View drives Coach Hatfield nuts, Mark. These mental penalties like that. You got a good drive going. And you just got first down, and you're deep in Chancellor's territory, and then you do a false start. So now you're first down and 15, and now you got to change your whole kind of play calling a little bit in order to see what you can do to pick up first down or get the big touchdown.
Okay, so after a 5-yard penalty, it's first and goal from the 15-yard line. Bill Butler, second throw of the night. He throws it behind the intended receiver, Blake Cleek, and we'll have second and goal coming up from the 15. Well, you know, this broadcast is made possible by Founding Sons, investing in youth at all levels to help make tomorrow's leaders. Founding Sons at 825-3530. 6:28 to play here in this first quarter, and this is second and goal from the 15.
Mark, on that play right there, looked like Blake and Till weren't on the same page. Looks like Blake turned inside and Till threw it to the outside.
All right, Sharina on the left. Lawson on the right of Butler. Sharina gets the call. Here's Sharina down close to the 6-yard line. Or make that rather the 11-yard line.
Sharina on the carry.
He picked up 4 yards. It's going to be third and goal now from the 11.
And Mark, we haven't seen Drew Sharina run the ball very much this season. And it's interesting to see how he runs. He brings a different style to that running attack for Eastern View. Gives him more versatility. But he does run, he protects the ball well, and he looks like he's a very strong runner, hard to bring down.
Well, you know, he's such a good athlete, and strong, determined, in shape, all that has the package, really. Here's Butler, fakes it. Now he's going to throw. He's got a receiver out there. It's Leak into the end zone from 11 yards out.
And they batten down the hatches, shut the door, lock the windows. It's a Cyclone touchdown. Till Butler to Blake Lee from about 11 yards. And Mark, that was a great play fake by Till Butler. Faked the handoff and he caught Chancellor napping. Though one player for Chancellor did come in and put pressure on Butler, he was able to get the pass completed to Blake Lee for the touchdown.
10 plays, 43 yards, and this drive consumed 6 minutes and 17 seconds. Capped by the 11-yard touchdown pass. From Till Butler to Blake Leak. 6-0, 5:43 to play. Now Butler the holder for Garrett Hutchinson. How good has Hutchinson been this year? Well, he's been virtually flawless. This kick is up and good. 7-0. Well, Hutchinson, he is now 53 of 56 on his extra point attempt. It's 7-0 Cyclones. 5:43 to play here in this first quarter. And this broadcast is made possible by Battlefield Automotive, a keystone of service and a cornerstone of our community. Battlefield Automotive at 547-3673. And their CFC Farm and Home Center, outfitting your family from head to toe since 1932. CFC Farm and Home Center at 825-2200. Well, Steve, good-looking drive by the Cyclones. They, of course, they took advantage of excellent field position from the Chancellor 43-yard line to start on offense. And They went 10 plays, and they had just the one setback, the five-yard penalty. Other than that, they looked pretty good. Butler threw twice, both times to Blake Leak. The first pass was thrown behind him. The second pass was right on target, and for the touchdown.
Yeah, it was an impressive drive, Mark. I was very impressed the way each of you handled themselves.
Well, the return there was by Kim Carruthers, number one. He generally wears jersey number 17. He's wearing number one tonight. And we're going to get our first look at Chancellor's offense, Steve, with 5:37 to play here in this first quarter. You know, when you think of the Chancellor offense, you pretty much have to start with that quarterback, Trevin Edwards.
Yeah, it all starts with him. If he's on, he's, you know, 6 foot, 177 pounds, and he's very quick, Mark. He will run the football, and he can throw it. He's got a good arm. East of View is going to be tested. You got to be disciplined and get pressure on him.
So Trevin Edwards, the quarterback. Let's see if he goes under center or more of a pistol formation here. He had a good week last week. Hands off to his running back, bounced outside the pack. Got across the 25-yard line, did Ziggy Carter.
Chancellor's going to be, they're going to try to run behind that big offensive line, Mark. And Drew Shereen and company, and Mikey King, and Alex Spangler, and those boys up front, Jason Southern and boys up front. He's got to, you know, be big. He's got to play big.
Okay, picked up six, a second and four. Chargers at the 27-yard line. They trail 7-0. This is Carter again, the ball carrier, and he takes a load with him, got across the 30, out to about the 33, and that'll be enough for a Chancellor first down. And in on the tackle is big number 99, Jordan Dotson for Eastern U.
Mark, you know, he's 5'9", 151 pounds, but Carter is deceptively strong, very, you know, quick, and he's just powerful. So he's already shown to be the load that he is, so it's going to be up to Eastern U to really get a hat on him.
Edwards handing off Carter once more. Carter hit near the line of scrimmage, got across the 35, 36, two-yard pickup. A couple of Cyclones in on the play of the tackle, and they included Jordan Breckley and number 78,
and, you know,
Elijah Hoskin.
And, you know, we did confirm, Mark, the head coach, Jeff Jugai's first year at Chancellor. He's trying to go away from the, you know, Chancellor was known for that wishbone offense of Coach Oliver and running that, you know, flex bone and everything else. So they're trying to, he's trying to go for a more balanced, you know, pro set, trying to see if he can get, you know, get some passing tackle. But again, looks like Chancellor just jumped off sides.
Waiting on Buffalo Wild Wing, your food's been ordered on its way.
Well, I think Max Preps had their record right, but they hadn't updated on the coaching change, had they?
Yeah.
Well, you know, this broadcast is made possible by UVA Community Credit Union. Your financial success enables us to be a positive force in the Culpeper community. UVA Community Credit Union, 888-887-9136. This is second and 13 here. This is Carter, the ball carrier, and getting a hold of him and making sure he didn't get away. Drew Shereena, tackle made at the 30-yard line, or the 31, so no gain on the play.
Also, Jordan Breckley in on also helping Shereena on the tackle right there. Now, Mark, big third down play here. See what the Eastern View defense got dialed up. Good. See if they can stop this rushing tackle of the Chancellor Chargers.
Okay, it's third and 13. Trevin Edwards there, the quarterback. Play action. It's going to be hit as he throws. This one looks like it's going to be caught around the 45-yard line. A diving catch made by number 21, Cody Moore. And that'll be enough for a Chancellor first down.
Defending was C.J. Taylor on the play, and looks like he's getting some ample playing time and plays Chance Gray's on the defensive side. Just was a little bit late getting there, Mark.
3:08 to play first quarter action. Cyclone 7, Chargers nothing, but this is each team has had the ball once. Eastern View drove for a touchdown, and here's Chancellor's turn trying to respond. They got a couple first downs on this drive. Ziggy Carter, looks like it went the other way. We were looking at Carter, and it looks like Edwards kept the ball, Trevin Edwards. He faked out a few people, including myself, as he got down to the Eastern View. Looks like inside the 45-yard line to the 43. So, Steve, what did you see that I didn't see?
He faked out everybody, Mark. even including me, he held that ball as long as he could and then just pulled it right out the last second of Carter's hands and ran around the left side. So we'll see. Yeah, what is there, a penalty on the play? Looks like there might be a penalty against the Chargers.
Yeah, because we didn't see a flag, but obviously there is one because they're marking it back right here.
The holding on the offense.
So it is a holding. That's a big call. So Chancellor had it at the their own 45-yard line, and on that play by Edwards, he picked up 12 yards. But they brought it back with a penalty, pushes the ball back to the 38-yard line.
But still going to be first down, Mark, because he had picked up the first down before the penalty.
So they mark it at the Chancellor 38, 2:44 to play, clock ticking, first quarter, 7-0 Eastern View. Chancellor, except for that holding penalty, had looked pretty good in this drive. They get back to run. The ball is loose. It's on the ground. Let's see who's got it. Now it looks like Eastern View has it.
Number five.
Well, I didn't see it.
Yeah,
they're pulling the. Okay, so number five is Cohen King, isn't it? No, I mean Zaire King. They're going to ring the bell. You know what that means.
Ring my bell. It's a defensive turnover. And what happened on that play? So we've got a Chancellor player hurt. It looks like the running back just didn't get the ball. Then, excuse me, kind of punted it forward. And whereas number five, Zaire King, was able to recover the football.
We got an injured or shaken up Charger player. It's number eight, Cameron Hawkins. Appears to be okay. So with the fumble, the turnover to Eastern View, the Cyclones will take over on the Chancellor's side of midfield at the 45-yard line. 2 minutes to play here, and there's actually 2:30 to play in this first quarter, and Eastern View up 7-0. Well, you know, this broadcast is made possible by Able Heating and Air. Able to keep your family comfortable through every season. Able Heating and Air at 718-7556. And Mama May's, our new location on Sperryville Pike, offers the same fresh pizza and subs. Always fresh, always good. Only Mama May's. 829-9200. All right. Up 7-0. The Cyclones back on offense. Outstanding field position for the second time tonight in two tries. And let's see what Till Butler draws up here with Rock Lawson on his right. Well, there's a bad snap, hits his knee, and now it looks like Chancellor has recovered it. That snap, it looked like it hit the knee and then bounced toward the Chancellor defenders, and they were able there to recover it, so a turnabout fair play for both teams here.
So sort of similar to what happened with Chancellor, Mark, and I can equate that, I think, to temperatures. It's cold tonight. Both teams probably have not played in this weather this cold, but again, that was a bad snap. It just hit Till Butler in the knee and bounded forward. And that's kind of like what happened with Chancellor, only they got a handoff and it hit the knee and bounded forward.
Yeah.
So now a turnover, now you give life to Chancellor. And again, this is what hurt Eastern View last week against the loss against Spotsylvania, were turnovers.
Okay, now Chancellor gets it back and with good field position from its own 47-yard line. Trevor Edwards is the quarterback, two receivers to the left and one to the right. Going to drop back to pass. Will the protection hold up? It does. He throws downfield long, and this one is picked off. And coming back is, this is number six. That's Logan. Josh Logan returns it. So another turnover. Wow, three plays and three turnovers. Absolutely. And both teams have been the beneficiaries of excellent field position. And Eastern View here on its third possession will start on its own 45-yard line. Butler going to keep it all the way. Comes to the near side, trips and falls just shy of midfield, down at about the 49. He'll pick up four. Second and six on its way as we are now under the two-minute mark in this first quarter. It's Eastern View 7, Chancellor nothing.
The mark right there, that was another bad snap that kind of messed up the timing of that play. And that's what, you know, if you're running like a timing offense a lot of times, bad snaps can kill you.
Second down and six. Three-man front for Chancellor here. They've got some size up front, don't they? That three-man front. They switch their defensive alignment when a penalty flag comes in. This may be a delay of game. Against Eastern View.
The timeout first? Did they get the timeout before the, yeah. Looks like they got a timeout.
Maybe they did, okay. first of three timeouts taken by Eastern View.
Timeout, Eastern View.
So we talk about this being the regular season finale, not just for these two teams, but every team, Steve, and crosstown rival Culpeper playing its last game of the season over at Millbrook tonight. And that's going to be a tough matchup for the Blue Devils. And if they don't win that, they're going to finish their regular season at 1-9 in a year that's been strange because their head coach never got to coach a game this year.
Yeah, that's true. And Culpeper is not going to see the playoffs because Northwestern region, they do it a little bit different. They do district champs and then two at large. So they only have six teams in their region go to the playoffs. And so pretty much got Liberty and Broad Run for a locked up spot for two. So there's probably about 17 fighting for four spots in that region.
All right, after the timeout, Eastern View back to work on second and six from its own 49-yard line. Butler throws across the field, intended for Blake Leake. Never had a chance for it. And it might have been a good thing because that pass was thrown in an area where if Leake had hauled it in, he would have had to break about two tackles to get any yardage, Steve.
It would have, Mark, and also it could have been intercepted in return for a pick six. I mean, Till kind of floated that ball out there, and he kind of hurried it. He rushed it. He didn't really let Blake get into the pattern. And, Till just kind of whipped it out there, but he's just got to, calm down a little bit and move the ball like they did in the first series. Now they're, third and, they got about third and six here, don't they?
Sure do, from their own 49-yard line. A minute 17 to play, clock stopped on the incomplete pass. And we got play action. Butler throwing downfield. He's got a wide open receiver. This one's caught by Spangler. No one around, no flag down. It's touchdown Cyclones, the second of the night.
Lock the front door, shut the windows, and it's a big story of a Cyclone touchdown.
51 yards, Butler to Spangler. And Steve, the thing about that is, Spangler made a good catch, but the thing was, he was wide open. The coverage was simply not there.
The coverage wasn't there, you're right. Let's go to replay on this. Drops back, showed off his arm, and then look at this. Alex Spangler, easy speed, got behind that secondary of Chancellor. Wide open, just a pitch and catch, touchdown.
Now, Till Butler, who threw the touchdown pass, will be the holder for Garrett Hutchinson, who's been virtually flawless this season. Hutchinson's kick is up. It's good. 14-0 Cyclones, a minute eight to play in this first quarter. And we've had touchdowns tonight by two touchdown passes. Till Butler to Blake Leake. For the first one, with 5:34 to play in the first quarter. And then here with a minute eight to play in the quarter, it was a 51-yard scoring strike from Till Butler to Alex Spangler. And Garrett Hutchinson, 2-for-2 in the point afters, and this year he's just, it's been a great season. I could see him being a candidate for All-State myself, Steve. He's now 54 of 57 on the year in extra points. He's 2-of-3 for field goals, the longest of which was 38 yards. And these statistics provided courtesy of Devin Payne of the Culpeper Star Exponent. So coming into this game, Butler was 58 of 97 passing, 1,266 yards, 22 touchdowns, and only one interception, and that's huge. Of course, they missed Chance Graves as a receiver. They got some other kids, of course, Leake and Spangler doing the job for them this year. Here's a return man being hit hard after he got across the 25-yard line, picked up off his feet, finally dragged to the ground was Donovan Williams, the return specialist for Chancellor. So Chancellor's going to have average field position with 58 seconds to play in this first quarter, trailing 14-0. They're going to start this one from its own 27-yard line.
Basically, what they're going to have to do defensively, see if they can hold Chancellor. They held him up pretty good last time, even though there were a couple of little hiccups. But again, they're just going to have to play solid defense and not give up the big play.
Okay. Well, Trevin Edwards is the quarterback. He wears jersey number 19. He's in what I'm going to call a pistol formation, a couple backs back there. And he hands it off to Ziggy Carter. Carter had played pretty well earlier, but this time they wrapped him up the line of scrimmage, forcing back no gain. Just two or three different Cyclones in the tackle, including Mikey Keene, the linebacker.
And Mark, what they do is they go after the football, and that's one trait about Eastern View defense.
We also
they go
like
after
to
the football.
Yeah, football team they, like to thank Pepper's Restaurant.
There's not really a lot of big individual standouts. They all come to that football very, very, you know, that's a trademark of the Eastern View defense.
No gain on the play. Second and 10 now is the call. 25 seconds and counting here in this first quarter. And Chancellor spreads it out. Three receivers to the left, one at the top of your screen. Edwards going to throw, and on the slant, this is picked off by Spangler. Spangler breaks the tackle, and they tackle him down at the 15-yard line, where yet another turnover and another interception. But this ball was deflected off the hands of the intended receiver, and Spangler was there waiting for it, Steve.
It was a typical play, and they just right there at the right spot. Alex Spangler, fourth interception, and a turnover. Now gives Eastern View Cyclones excellent field position for their offense, Mark, and they look like they want to come out and just pace Chancellor and just send a message that that loss to Spotsylvania was not typical Cyclone football.
No, that you've said it. A lot of people have said it on any given night. You know, you fill in the blank there. Anything can happen, right?
Anything can happen on any given night.
All right, now, Eastern View with 8.5 seconds to play in this first quarter takes over at the Chancellor 17-yard line. And on the receiver around, kind of get the handoff with Eli Harris. On the end around, he picked up close to seven yards. That's going to be the final play of this first quarter. With our score, Eastern View 14, Chancellor nothing. We'll take a quick break and come back to the start of the second right after this.
Not everyone is an HVAC expert. Luckily, with 20 years of experience, Able Heating and Air can answer any and all questions you may have about your system. Peace of mind and knowledge that you've made the right choice, because they are able to keep your home comfortable. Able Heating and Air. Battlefield Automotive is proud to continue support of our high school youth and the Culpeper community. Winner of the prestigious Ford President's Award for a record 13 consecutive years. Battlefield Automotive, a keystone of service and a cornerstone of our community. CFC Farm and Home Center, hometown service since 1932. Finding the right outerwear for the job is difficult. Luckily, you'll find Carhartt clothing, Red Wing, and Irish Setter boots. From head to toe, it's easy to outfit with CFC Farm and Home Center. Found in Sons Funeral Chapels has made it their business to provide solutions during difficult times for over a quarter of a century. During that time, they've also made an investment in our youth through football, basketball, softball, baseball, lacrosse, and 4-H, among other projects. Good luck to tonight's teams, and do your best. Mama May's Pizza and Subs at our new location on 620 Sperryville Pike still serves you the best in pizza, subs, salads, and so much more. Always fresh, always good, only Mama May's. UVA Community Credit Union is a not-for-profit financial cooperative owned by individual members like you. Your financial success enables us to offer better products and services to all of our members and to be a positive force in the Culpeper community.
Welcome back to our broadcast. Cyclone Stadium's the place where it's windy and cold. And Mark O'Connell alongside Steve Peacock, Johnny Krawcheck behind the camera up top. And he dressed appropriately for the weather. He was prepared, dressed in layers, wool socks, boots, probably flannel-lined jeans. Phil Butler handing off, straight ahead. Rock Lawson breaks the tackle and into the end zone on the first play from the second quarter to make it 20-0 from 10 yards out.
Shut the windows, lock the front doors, bat down the hatches. It's a cyclone! Touchdown, Rock Lawson from 11 yards out. On the handoff from Phil Butler, bashes it right out the middle.
Opening play of this third quarter, and it's 20-0. Now Garrett Hutchinson on to draw his third extra point of the night. It's 2 for 2. Phil Butler, the holder. Is this one on the verge of maybe getting away from Chancellor? Is it too early to say?
It could be, Mark, right here. If they don't score in this next possession, Chancellor, this could be getting out of hand.
All right, let's see if Hutchinson can connect as he has consistently done throughout his career with the Cyclones.
Yeah,
so it looks like Chancellor's Donovan Williams jumped.
across the line of scrimmage.
You tried to hide back like a little secret squirrel.
Yeah, you didn't see me do that.
You didn't see me, did you? No, no, double me.
I would think they move it half the distance of the goal here.
Which way did he go?
So they move it half the distance. Is that the one?
And members of the field hockey team.
It doesn't make much of a difference to your kicking team, does it, when it's at this point, does it?
No, not that distance. Yeah. I mean, sometimes teams might say, oh, we might go for two, but each of you wants to go right here for the
Here's extra point.
And the kick is up and good. Hutchinson makes it 21-0, 11:53 to play here in the second quarter. So tonight was senior recognition night, Steve, and not just for the football team, but for cross country and cheerleading as well. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, the cheerleaders, coach Summerskills, is named 4B Cheerleading Coach of the Year, and Jalinda, I don't have her last name right here, but she was named, one of the cheerleaders, Jalinda, first name, was named the Cheerleader of the Year for the Region 4B, and they go to states tomorrow.
All right, so congratulations to the cheerleading team, Ben.
And 13.
So tonight, seniors soon.
Zero.
On these three different sports were recognized here at Cyclone Stadium before tonight's kickoff. So Garrett Hutchinson, as he's certainly gotten used to doing, has teed the football up once more to kickoff to his opponents, because the Cyclones, Steve, we have seen them the last few years just become a real scoring machine, haven't they?
Well, yeah, they have, and it just, we better get on it.
This ball goes over the head of the receiver. He touched it, but he went into the end zone. They ruled it a touchback. Maybe he didn't touch it.
Well, I mean, if you had replay, he touched it, but the officials are going to give him the benefit of the doubt because it should have been a safety. But again, Easterview has had a very successful run, Mark, in the regular season. They lost last week to a very, very hungry Spotsylvania team that just wanted it more than Easterview. I heard they came out flat. And now Spotsylvania's trailing King George 13-0.
Wow.
Big, big game for playoff implications. King George wins, they get in. And Spotsylvania could drop down to a fifth seed with the loss. And so that could have big doings here for Easternview as well. So,
but you were saying if Easternview wins tonight, they're likely going to be the three.
They're going to be
the third seed, which means they play a number six team in the first round, which would be Dinwiddie, right?
Well, could be Dinwiddie, or depending on, if Dinwiddie loses, Patrick Henry Vaslin wins, could be going against Patrick Henry Vaslin and Coach Wakefield.
Well, here is Ziggy Carter, the ball carrier, and the Cyclones do a nice job of stringing this play out, running him down shy of the line of scrimmage, or right at it anyway. So, yeah, that would be an interesting twist to think that Easternview could play Patrick Henry of Ashland in the first round when you consider two things. One, the last time a Culpeper-based team played Patrick Henry of Ashland was in 2001 in the state semis. And secondly, and probably more notably under the circumstances, Easternview would be playing a team coached by Ken Wakefield, who spent six seasons at Culpeper just this year. Right. So here is Edwards rolling to his right. Pressure coming. And now he throws it. This one is caught near the 30-yard line.
It's out of bounds. He caught it out of
Pass
bounds.
By Edwards there, but called out of bounds.
Nice catch, but off the playing field.
Well, I was going to tell you, Mark, going back to that playoff conversation, see, right now, Patrick Henry is in the seventh seed, okay? And they can move up with a win. And you got Huguenot in the eighth. Right trailing right behind is King George. So King George, and Huguenot's got to play, and Powhatan's down there in there too.
Mm-hmm.
Huguenot and Powhatan play each other tonight, so one of them is going to get knocked out tonight.
All right, here's Edwards on 3rd and 11 from the 19-yard line. He's looking for help. He got away from a couple of defenders, reverses his field, and Edwards finally brought down on the sack. Mikey Keene was able to wrap him up and take him down to the ground, and now that'll force a Chancellor punt.
And the other thing I was wanting to finish is up this, mm-hmm, Mark. The other unique thing about this 4B region is, everyone said Louisa plays Albemarle tonight, and they should beat them. And they'll finish 10-0. But if Monacan at 8-1 right now is at plays Crosby, which is 6-3, if Monacan beats Crosby tonight, they'll finish 9-1 and they'll go ahead of Louisa on the rating points.
High snap, short kick. A little bit of a Chancellor roll here as Spangler watches it go out of bounds. Out of bounds, rather, at the Chancellor 42-yard line. So again, outstanding field position coming up for Eastern View's offense. And the Cyclones are already up 21-0 with 10-12 to play here in the second quarter. You know, this broadcast is made possible by Able Heating and Air, able to keep your family comfortable through every season. Able Heating and Air at 718-7556. And Mama May's, our new location on Sperryville Pike, offers the same fresh pizza and subs, always fresh, always good, only Mama May's, 829-9200. So 10-12 to play here in the second quarter. 21-0 Cyclones on top. And now Eastern View back on offense at the Chancellor 42-yard line. And Till Butler has two receivers to the right. And we got a whistle and stoppage before this play can unfold. They're going to mark off 5 yards against the Cyclone offense. And I'll push it back to the 47-yard line. It will be first and 15.
Well, I was getting ready to say with Eastern View. So Eastern View, like I said, win or lose, they're probably going to be a third. But the unique thing is that Monacan, with a worse record than Louisa, could end up number one seed.
Here came the pressure. Butler decided to keep it. And they're going to stop him after about a yard gain. Making the tackle for Chancellor was Jaken Struthers. Big number 75 getting a break. See him run off the field there. Is Jordan Hall. There he goes. No gain. And it's second and 15 here. Clock running 9:40 to play second quarter. Alex Spangler goes top of your screen. And in the slot there will be Eli Harris to the right. Butler, Chancellor shows pressure. They hand it off and smothered in the backfield was Rock Lawson. Big number 55, Adam Smith. That's a big tackle for Chancellor, and he dropped him for a 2-yard loss.
Mark, he's 6 foot, 220. You know, that looks bigger than that. He just basically read that play all the way and just sacked him for a loss.
But, Steve, is this where Eastern View has kind of thrived on third and long situations?
Yep.
We've seen them get pushed back, and you go, what's going on? It's third and 15, third and 17. Then they hit on a big play, and it's like they just sort of shake off the – bad situation, third and long.
That's what they got to do, and their big play capability of Eastern View. We'll see if we can see it right here.
He's third and 17 from the 49-yard line. Here's Butler. He's throwing, and this one off the hands of the intended receiver, Alex Spangler. He would have caught it at the Chancellor 40-yard line, and it would have been shy of a first down. And now we'll see Garrett Hutchinson kick. For the first time as a punter tonight.
Spangler was kicking himself in the butt because even if he caught it, he still had room. You would have probably picked up the first down. But he, again, guilty of trying to run before he catches it.
He would have had to pick up about 8 yards on his own after the catch, Steve, to get it. He may have. He has that breakaway ability, of course. All right, Garrett Hutchinson will punt for the first time tonight at the 40-yard line. High kick. This one will not be returned. It'll take a Cyclone roll, and they're going to down it at the 15-yard line. So a nice job by Hutchinson to pin the Chargers back shy of the 20-yard line.
It's cold out there tonight, people. It's the coldest night of the season so far. And, again, you know, you're going to see the defense can, you know, force another turnover here against Chancellor.
All right. 8:34 to play, second quarter action. Eastern View 21, Chancellor nothing. This broadcast is made possible by UVA Community Credit Union. Your financial success enables us to be a positive force in the Culpeper community. UVA Community Credit Union at 888-887-9136.
Right now, Mark, you got Blake Leak on the sideline. Looks like he has an equipment problem. And in for his place, number six. You know, Josh Logan moved to his deep safety spot.
Here's the handoff to Kim Carruthers. Carruthers picks up good yardage as Eli Harris forces him out of bounds near the 30 or 25-yard line, it looks like.
Carruthers was their big running back this year, you know, but he got injured. He got hurt. And he was their big workhorse at the beginning of the season, and it looks like he's back with a vengeance.
Actually picked up 18 yards out to the 33. Here's a pitch to Carruthers coming near side. Gets away from one tackle, then Mikey Keene. And some help there from his teammate, number 69. That is Jordan Breckley, make a nice tackle with Carruthers.
Again, you know, it's like.
No gain.
Carruthers was there, like I said, you got to watch out for him. Mm-hmm. Got to watch out for the quarterback, and you also got to watch out for Brown, the other quarterback.
Well, so it was Carruthers who, as a wide receiver, 481 yards receiving this year. All right, stepping up is Edwards, going to keep it and going to be tackled after he crossed the 35. We'll mark it at the 37. He picked up 4 yards. Third and six coming up here. And when the clock runs, 7:30 to play.
Third down play here for the Cyclones. See if they can stop him here, force a punt. Because I don't think Chancellor will go for it and fourth in their own territory. Getting a play from the sidelines. I know we're in the press box, Mark, but it's cold up here.
Yeah, it is. Well, I'll tell you, this broadcast is made possible by Battlefield Automotive, a keystone of service and a cornerstone of our community. Battlefield Automotive, 547-3673. And one of these two teams.
Timeout, Chancellor.
Chancellor just called a timeout. I think they're a little confused out there. Also, this broadcast is made possible by CFC Farm and Home Center, outfitting your family from head to toe since 1932. CFC Farm and Home Center at 825-2200. All right, 7:01 to play. Second quarter, Cyclone Stadium, where it's windy and cold. And it's 21-0 in favor of the Cyclones. And after the timeout, the Chargers will have a third and six from their own 36-yard line. We mentioned this being the last regular season game. And Eastern View, if they win tonight, will finish the regular season at 9-1. And Chancellor came in at 5-4. And they're vying for a playoff spot. So they've got good incentive to play well and hard here tonight. And, of course, Culpeper, we mentioned, is on the road at Millbrook in a tough matchup against the Pioneers. And so far, Culpeper with one win this year against Monticello. They're 1-8, wrapping up the season tonight on the road at Millbrook High School. All right, here on third and six, as Edwards rolling to his left, throwing downfield. That pass looks like it's going to be caught at the 35-yard line. Despite excellent coverage, making the nice catch there for Chancellor was number 21, Cody Moore. And a big first down play for Chancellor.
And Mark, it was a good catch. I thought it was good coverage there, but what happened was I didn't see the defensive back for the Cyclones make a play on the ball, and he didn't get his head turned around fast enough.
All the way down to the Eastern View 35-yard line. It is a 28-yard pickup, and Carruthers, the ball carrier, they wrap him up after a nominal gain. Eli Harris, Rock Lawson in the tackle for Eastern View. He picked up just a yard. We'll mark it at the 34. It's 2nd and 9. 6:20 to play here in the second quarter. Checking in is Kim Carruthers, number one there. You see him. And he comes to the near side as a receiver. In fact, Chancellor's going to send three to the side, to the right side. One top of your screen here on 2nd and 9. And this is Trevin Edwards. Here comes the pressure, steps up. Edwards going to keep it, and he's tripped up. Rock Lawson makes a solo tackle out there.
Edwards on the keeper.
Yeah. You're going to see a lot tonight from that of Chancellor, Mark. They're going to look like they're going to get in a pro set with trips to the right or left, and they're going to look like they're going to throw, and then the quarterback drops back, and it's a design play, quarterback draw, and he's trying to see if he can find a hole in that Eastern View defense and try to get past that first level and pick up big yards.
All right, he picked up 3 yards. It's 3rd and 6 here for the Chargers at the Cyclones 31-yard line. Edwards tries to avoid the pressure, but unable to avoid the tackle made by big number 99, Jordan Dotson, making the tackle, and it's going to bring up fourth down. We'll check the spot here. Looks like it's back at the 34-yard line, so that's a three-yard sack.
Jordan Dotson's bigger than 5'10", 225, Mark. Mm. He's got to be at least 6'1", 6'2".
I don't see the Eastern View front four as big as their opponents, but they seem to have quickness and good smarts to that football, don't they?
Yep, big fourth down play here.
Fourth and nine now for the Chargers from the Cyclone 34. Edwards flushed out, throws, and he's got a receiver out there, caught or incomplete.
Incomplete.
Looks like he had him, and I guess he dropped the ball. It was intended for number 21, Cody Moore. Remember, Moore had a big catch on this drive to keep it going. And instead, they're going to turn it over on downs to Eastern View.
Even if he did catch a mark, it would have been questionable when he had a foot enough in bounds. I know you only need one in high school and college, but it would have been kind of questionable.
All right, so Eastern View goes back on offense. This time they're going to start from its own 34 with 4:42 to play here in the second quarter. It's been all Cyclones, 21-0 our score. Till Butler, the quarterback. He and his teammates come back onto the field. Drew Sharina will be in the backfield on Butler's left. Rock Lawson on his right. Two receivers to the left. It looks like this is going to be Sharina as the lead blocker for Rock Lawson. And he's going to get just a yard on the play.
And it looks like, you know, the Chancellor defense up front, big number 75, Jordan Hall, 5'8", 325.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's called a fire hydrant and a half in there.
Chancellor showing pressure. Got that big number 75 in that three-man front right there at the nose guard. See him?
Yep. He's like moving a fire hydrant, or two of them.
If the question was, where's the beef, you would say right there in the middle. You're looking at him.
He's
taking up some
room. He didn't turn down a meal for mama.
All right, this is Rock Lawson, left side. Short gain, right at the 40-yard line. Bring a third down here in about four or five. Third and four, we'll call it, from the 40. Clock continues to move, 3:40, counting.
We see Eastern View passing the ball here, or we see them see if they're going to go to the run.
You know, they really do. They always have options, don't they?
They do.
And they're never deterred by a third and long. Now, this is not a third and long. It's third and short, third and four. Quite manageable for this team. Chancellor showing pressure. Now they back off. Butler. Pump fakes. We got a penalty flag down. This one did not look right from the beginning, Steve.
No, it didn't. Looked all messed up from the beginning. It's going to be false start against Eastern View.
Push them back 5 yards. It's going to bring up third and nine.
And this is where things that they can't have happen, Mark, in playoff football.
Mm-hmm.
Against the better teams they're going to face, because every possession counts. And if you can't move the ball in four downs, and because you created, you know, cost yourself, made yourself two costly penalties, mm-hmm. that hurts. So you got to get that cleaned up.
All right, so it's third and nine from the 35-yard line for Eastern View. Just under 3 minutes to play in this first half. Here's Butler. Pump fakes it. Now he's going to throw it, put it up in the air, let his receiver run under it. And this one looked like it was going to be intercepted. It was broken up by the receiver, who ended up playing defender on the play.
Yeah, Eli Harris became a defender on that play, because that would have been Till Butler's second interception of the season had it gone down.
Got a little bit of a conference going on here, as though it may have been an infraction on the play. Let's see what the call is going to be. It's an incomplete pass, would bring up fourth and nine if that play stands.
But is it Chancellor going to accept it and push him back further? And try to get themselves better field position on the punt.
Or here comes the call from the official. Pass interference against Eastern View declined. Now it's fourth down.
Yeah, because it looked like Harris had to interfere, because he had to run as hard as he could and dive right in front of the Chancellor defender.
All right, we'll see Garrett Hutchinson in the punting unit for the second time tonight. And Hutchinson's going to stand near his 20-yard line. We got a whistle, we got stoppage, and likely a timeout called All right, well, we'll tell you with the timeout that this broadcast is made possible by Founding Sons, investing in youth at all levels to help make tomorrow's leaders. Founding Sons at 825-3530. All right. So 2:46 to play. You're on this cold and windy night at Cyclone Stadium. Cyclones up 21-0. What are your thoughts or analysis about this first half, Steve, for both teams? Beginning with Eastern View, what have you seen so far that you like, and what do you think we need to sort of shore up as we go into the playoffs?
Well, let's start with they need to shore up penalties. That's easy. That's an easy answer to that question.
Mm-hmm.
What they need to do better, and I think they've got to, you know, they've got some injuries, so they're going to have to figure that out and, you know, go. I like to see Blake Leak touch the ball more. He's one of your better athletes, and basically just get the passing game down.
And we're going to return to your analysis here in just a moment. We got a penalty flag thrown on this 4th and 9.
It looks like it's going to be a false start against Easterview. So that's going to be fourth and 14. But what I'd like to see, the penalty is the big thing, Mark. But in order, you know, better offensively, better running attack, I think they solved that issue with Drew Sherina giving him some reps at the running back position. But again, you know, get more of a running game established so it opens up the passing attack. I think that's what they like to work on. And then on defensively, not much. He's pretty handled pretty much defensively. They're doing a good job.
All right, Hutchinson will now punt from about the 20. There's his kick. Not a high kick. And it does not take a bounce. It just falls flat there, or bounces flat rather, at the 45-yard line of Chancellor. So Chancellor will have excellent field position as the Chargers send their offensive unit back onto the field, trailing 21-0 with 2:32 to play here in this first half.
Marty, it looks like to me, it's kind of been of a lull here in the second quarter here.
Yeah.
Eastview came out like gangbusters first quarter, scored 21 points, but here second quarter, it looks like the both teams kind of stagnated a little
bit. Okay, so the quarterback, Trevin Edwards, number 19, and that is Carter. They fake it to Carter. Edwards keeps it. He broke the tackle. Eastern View territory down at the 45-yard line. It's a pickup of about 10 yards. Looks like it's enough to move the sticks, or maybe it's going to be just about a half yard shy.
It's a quarterback that's got the ball handling skills of Edwards right there, Mark. That's what's hurting Eastern View a little bit, because he's very adept at pulling that ball out at the last minute.
Okay, second down and very short here. Approaching that 2-minute mark of the second quarter. Edwards, here comes the pressure. And he can't get away from the grasp of number 7. And that is C.J. Taylor.
Taylor came in from his defensive end position, but I think it was, they didn't give him the first down. It's like third and about.
Yeah, well, right there it was exactly no gain.
Yep.
It was no gain at all. Not even an inch. It's third and 1 from the 46 of Eastern View. Edwards rolls to his left. Here comes the pressure. He got away from one defender, makes a nice cut, makes a defender miss. He's at the Eastern View 30. They'll force him out of bounds, just shy of that 25-yard line where you were just talking about. Edwards' running ability, and there he showed us an excellent example of just what you were talking about.
Yep, he's hard to contain. He's a good athlete. And the fans in the
battlefield, so, and the region 4B championship.
Now it's going to be now first down for Chancellor. They're going to look to try to get seeds of momentum and get a score here before halftime.
Well, they have a minute and 18 still remaining on this clock, and they have the ball first and 10 at the Cyclones 27. So Trevin Edwards, nice bit of footwork on that last run. The first down yardage. Now he's going to throw, and he's got a receiver near side. Caught near the 15-yard line marker was Donovan Williams, the receiver.
Donovan Williams on the reception for a first down.
Right there at the 15. He picked up 12 yards. And it's first and 10 from the 15-yard line. Minute 13. Clock stop with the complete pass. And when the receiver went out of bounds. So Trevin Edwards Now moving this team within striking range now. Plenty of time for the Chargers, and they're going to be the beneficiaries of a five-yard penalty. Rob sides against Eastern View, it looks like here.
Number 69. That is big Jordan Breckley.
And there's the five-yard mark off.
Offside
moves it down to the 10. And that'll make it first and five. So the Chancellor can get a first down without scoring and get the ball down where they can punch it in with four tries, unless Eastern View, of course, can force a turnover here. So now Edwards leads his team back to the line of scrimmage on first and five. They have it marked at the 10. That's Ziggy Carter behind him. Edwards in a little bit of trouble. And this one is caught after the deflection, and this one's going to be out of bounds at about the one-yard line. What a play there. That was deflected, and hauling it in was number 15, Jason Struthers.
Yeah, it looks like number four, Rock Lawson, deflected the pass, mm-hmm. Right into it, and then 15 came right across there and looked like he almost thought he had a touchdown.
Well, now Steve Chancellor has four downs here to try to punch it in from the one-yard line. It's first and goal from that spot. Edwards back there, the quarterback. Ziggy Carter behind him. Long snap count. Now Edwards looks to the sidelines for some instructions. That Chancellor knocking at the door seriously here in the final minute and 6 seconds as Carter waltzes right into the end zone. Touchdown Chancellor with a minute four to play in the second quarter. And that's the Chargers' first points of the night. And it comes on a one-yard run by Ziggy Carter. But Steve, this drive was really propelled by the quarterback, Trevin Edwards.
It was. It was Edwards all the way. He was their sole offense, throwing in, running the football, and got loose for a big third down on a third down play. Got loose for a big one and was able to.
They go muddle huddle here, don't they?
Yeah, they're trying to confuse Eastern View.
And there's a snap that Edwards has hard time handling. Now he's in trouble, and he goes down. On the tackle made by number 7 of Eastern View, C.J. Taylor. And so this two-point conversion fails. 21-6 our score, a minute four to play. Let's look at that Chancellor drive. Of course, after that punt, Chancellor took over on its own 45-yard line, and really it was a couple of big plays. That one run by Trevin Edwards really kept that drive going, and he moved it down to the Eastern View 27 where they just sort of were able to put it together after that. But I thought Trevin Edwards really sort of saved the day for his team to keep that drive going.
He did, Mark. You couldn't set any better. He was their sole offense, basically, in that big third down run where he got away from a couple of Eastern View tacklers. You can't arm tackle this quarterback. You got to bring him down, and he was able to propel his team down and were able to score 6 points. Now, the Eastern View, be careful here for the onside kick.
And so one of the things I want to say is that with Chancellor scoring so late in this first half, it's a two-score game right now. It's 21-6. If they were to stop Eastern View on its next possession and go into the intermission, remember, Chancellor won the toss and deferred. They're going to receive the kickoff when we start the third quarter.
It looks like they're going to try to see if they can do an onside kick here.
I know they keep it short. This one's going to be fielded at the 15-yard line. This is Spangler, 40, 45, midfield. Breaks a tackle and a second tackle. Changes his direction, and they're going to finally bring him down just shy of the 20-yard line. And so after Chancellor scores, this is returned by Spangler, gives Eastern View a chance to reply.
Well, Mark, let's go to replay on this. Look at this kickoff. Look at Spangler making a run here, cutting back, running up the sidelines, but is there a flag on the play?
I think you gave him a sideline warning.
Yeah, sideline warning.
Mm-hmm.
And look right here, and he's Alex Spangler breaking the tackle right here at about the 30-yard line. Looks like he's going to go in the end zone, but he gets brought down right about on the Chancellor 20-yard line. Good run, good return by Alex Spangler. Now, Mark, that puts Chancellor in Garrett Hutchinson's range for a field goal at least if they can't get a touchdown.
Well, his longest of the year is what, 38 yards?
Mm-hmm.
He's had two field goals, and his longest is 38. He's 2 or 3. But they've got time to think about a touchdown here as well. Drew Sherina gets the carry, and he slips through the tacklers for a couple yards there. The line of scrimmage was a 21, and so he gets to the 18. He picked up 3. Second and seven, clock runs 35 seconds to play. So now we get into this clock management situation for Till Butler.
Yeah, they got to hurry up. I mean, they only got one timeout left.
Here's Butler throwing. This is Spangler. Spangler on the move, breaking a tackle. There goes Spangler, he's in from 18 yards out.
Well, we got a flag on the play, though. We got a flag on the field.
He's not going to like that one.
It's a Cyclone touchdown. Let's see, we can see who the call is. The officials are calling it back. Might be a legal shift.
And Sarah Hatfield will be kicking the field goal kicking at the end of the third quarter for Battlefield Ford, 100 times.
Look like it's going to be.
Yeah, and that's just the play.
I
was going to say it's a touchdown. It's against each. I'm sorry. Hang on just a second. See, it looks like the call is going to work against Chancellor. And so they're going to wave the flag off, and here comes Steve Peacock after that touchdown by Alex Spangler.
Shut the front doors, lock the windows, bat down the hatches, and it's a big storm warning because it's a cyclone. Touchdown. Butler and Spangler, that combination's been working all season long.
Sure has. 27-6, our score with 20.9 seconds to play. And remember, this score comes right on the heels of Chancellor putting its first points on the scoreboard at a minute and four to play. And it was the kickoff return by Spangler that really set up this excellent field position as Eastern View took over on the Chancellor 21-yard line. Didn't take him but two plays to score as Garrett Hutchinson's kick.
Good.
It's up as good as 28-6. Cyclones with 20.9 seconds to play here in this first half.
And Mark, with any momentum that was gained by that Charger touchdown, just got negated by that two play by Alex Spangler, basically.
Yeah.
Kickoff and then the touchdown after the Drew Serena short run. Then you had Alex Spangler in for 11 yards out for the touchdown.
And if anyone in our viewing audience may be wondering why you have not heard us mention the name Chance Graves as a player tonight, it's because he's out for the season with a knee injury.
He's out zero ACL in the paper, and he's done for the season. It's a blow to Chancellor. But, he was on the sidelines on crutches.
6-3-0-2-8-0. 6-3-0.
So Garrett Hutchinson will tee it up at the 40-yard line.
Get that winning ticket. Come on up to the press box.
28-6 in favor of Eastern View. 20.9 seconds to play. We're remaining in this first half. And here is Hutchinson's kick. Keeps it on the ground. Good hands there by Chancellor's number 13, Braden Drigetz.
That's the
coach's son. His first name is what, Jeff?
Jeff.
Jeff Drugetz, head coach, first year. So what do we know about Drugetz as a first-year coach? Any memory of him coaching at other teams?
No, I don't, Mark. I mean, I've heard the name. I think he's been involved in coaching in Spotsylvania County in different schools, but first season head coach.
Well, let's go. Here's a trivia question for Steve. I think you'll get this one right. Who was a longtime head coach at Chancellor for 30-plus years? When we started broadcasting, he was coaching Chancellor, and they ran the wishbone.
Coach Bob Oliver.
Yeah, Bob Oliver. All right, here's Edwards. He's in trouble.
Edwards.
He goes down. Mikey Keene makes the big sack. Final 5 seconds ticking off, and both teams going to let this clock expire. And now it's official. First half is in the books. Two teams go to the locker rooms with the Cyclones well out in front. 28-6. We'll take a break. Come back when the third quarter is set to start. Keep it right here. You're watching Cyclones football on the Culpeper Media Network.
Not everyone is an HVAC expert. Luckily, with 20 years of experience, Able Heating and Air can answer any and all questions you may have about your system. Peace of mind and knowledge that you've made the right choice because they are able to keep your home comfortable. Able Heating and Air. Battlefield Automotive is proud to continue support of our high school youth and the Culpeper community. Winner of the prestigious Ford President's Award for a record 13 consecutive years. Battlefield Automotive, a keystone of service and a cornerstone of our community. CFC Farm and Home Center, hometown service since 1932. Finding the right outerwear for the job is difficult.
Luckily, you'll find Carhartt clothing, Red Wing, and Irish Setter boots. From head to toe, it's easy to outfit with CFC Farm and Home Center. Found in Sons Funeral Chapels has made it their business to provide solutions during difficult times for over a quarter of a century. During that time, they've also made an investment in our youth through football, basketball, softball, baseball, lacrosse, and 4-H, among other projects. Good luck to tonight's teams, and do your best. Mama May's Pizza and Subs at our new location on 620 Sperryville Pike still serves you the best in pizza, subs, salads, and so much more. Always fresh, always good, only Mama May's. UVA Community Credit Union is a not-for-profit financial cooperative owned by individual members like you. Your financial success enables us to offer better products and services to all of our members and to be a positive force in the Culpeper community.
All right, welcome back to Cyclone Stadium in our broadcast tonight. The Culpeper Media Network bringing you the action here of this Eastern View versus Chancellor football game. Garrett Hutchinson kicks off to start the third quarter. And Kim Carruthers has trouble finding a handle, and he picked it up near the one-yard line. Now he's looking for some running room, and he's not going to find any. As I think the whole Cyclone kickoff team was right there around at the point of the football, and Chancellor trailing 28-6 as we start the third quarter is going to be trapped deep in its own territory to start things here on offense.
Well, Mark, first he had a whole bunch, he's breaking a whole bunch of tackles, but he was running sideways, and I said, uh-oh. Right. Don't get loose and get down that sideline, but good pursuit there by Eastern View and putting Chancellor deep in their own territory. It looks like about, what they got to do, 9-yard line, I think?
What you were saying, he ran a lot of yards to get to the 8-yard line.
He did. He ran sideways.
So, Trevin Edwards brings the Chargers out on offense as we start the third quarter. And they're going to keep it on the ground as Edwards fakes it. And they trap him and tackle him at the 5-yard line for a 4-yard loss. Several Cyclones in on the tackle, including Rock Loss at number 4. So it'll drop him for a 3-yard loss at second and 13.
Mark got a score update. He got King George at halftime leading Spotsylvania 20-0.
How about that?
It's going to be good for Eastern View because Eastern View wins this game and that score holds. Eastern View will be the Battlefield District champion.
Well, and you know, we also heard that Millbrook was leading Culpeper at the half by only 7-6. How about that?
7-6.
Kevin Edwards here. That's Carruthers in motion, reverses direction. Edwards going to keep it, and he's going to be wrapped up shy of the 10-yard line. This puts it back to the original line of scrimmage at the 8
Edwards
or 9. And he gets back those 4 lost yards. We'll have 3rd and 9 on its way here.
Yeah, they still got to be a bit play on their toes, this defense, because of Edwards and his capability of throwing the football and running the football. It looks like they're going to go to like a hurry-up offense. It looks like Edwards is not even lined up a quarterback, number 11. He looks like he is going to, Edwards is 19, excuse me.
On third down.
Brothers.
Yeah, probably so. 3rd and 10. High snap. Edwards gets it down. Now he's throwing incomplete out there. And fourth down. And here comes the Chancellor punting team.
Now. Got a good return man, Alex Spanger, run that punt back. You know Chancellor's not going to try to punt to him. So here I would go all out for the block. Deep in their own territory, see if you can get a touchdown off of it. What do you think?
I like setting up the return because you got Spangler back there. Pretty much guaranteed great field position. Why go for the block and maybe pick up a penalty, because that seems to happen a lot. But you may be right. Here's the punt. Spangler drops back, fields it at about the 45-yard line. He gets away from the first tackler, tries to spin away from the second, and slinging him to the ground there was number 5, Ziggy Carter. No, and let's see, still excellent field position as Spangler returned it about 15, 20 yards on the play.
It looks like where they're going to mark the football, Mark. They're talking. Is there a penalty out there?
I didn't see one.
I didn't either. Laundry's hard to find, but then the officials get together in conference, so leads to the speculation that there might be a little bit of laundry on the field.
I think if I were the referee, I would wear the hat he's wearing because, you know, it covers the ears. Don't you find your ears getting really cold?
Well, if your ears get cold, the rest of your head gets cold. If your head gets cold, the rest of your body gets cold.
And if the body gets cold, then your whole body's cold.
There's a flag down here at the corner. Let's see what the...
Here it is right there. So that's a personal foul face mask.
Against Chancellor.
Yep. We're going to mark this one off here when it's all said and done. And Eastern View going to have... excellent field position.
That's unusual. Usually not the beneficiary of the penalty. So.
Yeah, you, that hasn't been their penalties. Have really been the thing that has been the maybe the point of contention or critique against Eastern View, don't you think?
Yep.
15-20-22 is the spot here for Eastern View's offense. And this is Eastern View's first possession of this third quarter. Outstanding field position at the Chancellor 22 for Till Butler and company. Here comes the pressure. Butler runs away from it. And he's at about the 18-yard line. Four-yard pickup, second and six on its way. Several Chargers in on the tackle, including Braden Driggett's coach's son. They mark it at 13, or 18, really. It's second and six. A long snap count here.
Clock run down. Be your friend.
Yeah, clock running 9:30 to play third quarter action. 28-6 our score. Eastern View, that was the score at the intermission. Here's Butler throwing near side. Spangler, the ball, the receiver, zigzagging his way inside the 15, down to about the 13. Short pickup, really.
Well, Alex is very smart, Mark, the way he runs. He waits for the pursuit. He sees it just right at the last minute. He makes him open pursuit because they're running right at him. Then he jukes one, runs for a little, you know, a couple yards, and then he tries to juke another. He tries to allow their overzealousness to get to him, you know, be the enemy, and he uses it against him.
Well, my view was hindered, and he picked up better yards than I thought. In fact, he got it down to the 6-yard line where it's first and goal, high snap. Butler gets it down, lowers his shoulder. He's inside the 10. He's at the 8. They had the ball at the 11, I guess it was, rather than the 6. My eyes are playing tricks on me here.
So he picked up a hard 3 yards, but that was a bad snap.
Well, now they definitely have it marked at the 7-yard line. This I know for certain. And it is second and six. So they could get a first down here without scoring. All right, we'll tell you this broadcast made possible by CFC Farm and Home Center. Helping your family from head to toe since 1932. CFC Farm and Home Center at 825-2200. All right. No question now as to where that ball is. It's at the 7-yard line. It's second and six. Cyclones here. 8:12 to play. Clock ticking. Third quarter. Till Butler. Rock Lawson along his side here. Lawson the ball carrier. Hit at the 5. Fighting for more yardage. He's down to about the 2. Maybe the 3-yard line depending on the spot. And the player who will get the credit for the tackle there was Chancellor's Austin Hall.
And Marky, David Jorgensen had equipment problems, replacement number 66. Big Nate Newton, the Eastern View Cyclones, 66. Offensive lineman.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they had equipment. David Jorgensen had a little equipment problem, he was getting it fixed, and there he comes, ready to come back and play.
Okay, so they're calling it third and 2 from the 3-yard line here. Will it be a first down? Lawson going to be stopped in his tracks. Now we got a decision
Lawson
to make.
Carry,
if it's going to be fourth and about
Chargers.
2 yards here, no gain on the play.
Back in the game is David Bergen.
Fourth and 2. Do you go for it or bring on Hutchinson for your field goal?
I think they're going to go for it because they don't want to seem like to run up the score, but I would go let Hutchinson try to tack on 3 points and use it for a future, you know, possibility in the playoffs.
Mm-hmm.
Get some experience there, but doesn't look like They're not going to do it.
Okay, so the ball is at the three. It's fourth and two for a first down. Rock Lawson till Butler. Butler going to take it. Straight ahead he goes. I don't think he's. Well, there he is. Second effort. He's down to about the just shy of that goal line. And on that second effort, Steve, he should have a first down. It should be first and goal.
First
and goal from that spot.
Good play there by Till Butler, Mark. That was good extra effort right there.
Yeah.
That extra effort is what got the first down.
Yeah, because it looked like they had him.
Yep.
And you're right. Second effort, he was able to lunge forward and get it to the one-yard line where it's first and goal from that spot. You might as well get those vocal cords warmed up, Steve. Got a feeling it's coming on this play. Will it be Lawson? Will it be Butler? It's going to be Lawson, and Lawson's in from 1 yard out.
It is, you know, you lock the front doors, you shut the windows, you batten down the hatches, and you know it's a storm coming. It's a cyclone. Touchdown, Rock Lawson from about 2 yards out.
34-6 Cyclone, 6:14 to play, third quarter. And Jared Hutchinson on to attempt his fifth extra point tonight. He's been perfect so far. He's been consistent throughout his career. And he came into tonight's game 52 of 55. And this is his fifth extra point try here. And the kick is up. And it hits the upright, and a rare miss for Hutchinson, who came in 52 of 55. That would make him tonight 56, now 56 of 59 on the year, I think it is.
Yeah, that kind of hit the upright. Thought when he kicked it, it was going to be a little bit wide right.
Strike that, 56 of 60, because he was 52 of 55. He's had five tonight. And he's connected on four of those, so it's 52 of 60 on the year. All right, and it's 34-6 Eastern View.
So that means Eastern View is getting a 35-point run clock.
They need another touchdown, right?
Yeah, touchdown.
All right, Steve, who is this broadcast made possible by? You were saying, Founding Sons, investing in youth at all levels to help make tomorrow's leaders. Founding Sons, 825-3530, and Battlefield Automotive, a keystone of service and a cornerstone of our community. Battlefield Automotive at 547-3673. 6:14 to play, third quarter action, 34-6, and Garrett Hutchinson again, kickoff for Eastern View. It's a short kick. This one's going to be fielded inside the 15-yard line. This is Ziggy Carter. And they're going to make contact and push him back at about the 25-yard line, and he doesn't like the fact they held on to him for a little longer than he would have liked.
Well, Mark, you know, I was just thinking, even if Easter View does score another touchdown, that only puts him up. That only puts him up by 34 points. They have to make the extra point in order to get that running clock. So, but you're going to see. I would now. Chancellor's going to have to go to the air, Mark. Keep running the football is not going to help them here.
Well, Chancellor's 6 points came with a minute four to play in the second quarter, and it looked like they had established a little momentum. Alex Spangler and the Cyclones almost immediately took it away from them. And it was 28-6 at the half, and the long points in this third quarter are the 6 points by Eastern View. A moment ago, in the 1 yard touchdown run by Rock Lawson. And the rare point after miss by Garrett Hutchinson. A 5 yard penalty works against Chancellor. We'll move it back to the 20 yard line. It'll be first and 15. And Steve, you're talking about going to the air. And I was watching Trevin Edwards, the quarterback, in his pregame drills, and he can throw that football.
Oh, he can throw it. Yes.
Play action. Here's Edwards. Here comes some pressure. Doesn't see it from the blind side. And he's hit from the back by big number 70, Jason Southern. Who caught him from the blind side. Edwards never saw him coming, and he did have the arm going forward, so it's an incomplete pass.
Yeah, it was a good pass rush by Southern right there, but also good coverage by the secondary, Eastern View.
Second and 15 from the 20. But I was talking, looking at Edwards in his pregame drills, he's got some zip on the football, and he can throw it in a spot with great accuracy. But let's see. Here's Ziggy. The ball is loose. Eastern View looks like they're going to have it. The handoff was to Ziggy Carter. It never looked like he really had possession, Steve. And once they made contact, it popped out of there, and Eastern View was all over it. And this could be put Eastern View in a position where they can go up by that 35-point differential, start moving this clock. Another turnover. I don't have the official count, but I think it's four on the night.
Yeah, it's just four on the night, Mark. You're right. Now brings up Eastern View from their 10-yard line, see if they can make Chancellor pay for their turnover.
Here comes that offensive unit. They typically know how to capitalize on an opponent's mistake. One of the players checking in right now for Eastern View is Greg Bradley, number 17, Steve. We haven't called his name tonight, but he's a receiver at the top of your screen. Rock Lawson lines up on the right of Till Butler. Drew Sharina on his left. Here's Drew Sharina getting the call. And he gets down to about the 7 or 8 yard line.
Eastern View is going to look like they're going to try to run this in, Mark, chew up clock, and then hopefully they can go up by, get the whole fourth quarter as a running clock.
Second goal now from the 7. Drew Sharina, Till Butler, Rock Lawson in that Eastern View backfield. Your center is number 70, Jason Southern. Eli Harris, receiver top of your screen. Out of view right now is Butler. Here comes Harris on the end around. There he goes. 5. And then into the end zone from 7 yards out. There he is. Number 8. Eli Harris makes it 40-6. And Steve, a point extra away from getting that 35-point differential.
There's a flag on the play, but let's see if the touchdown stands, Mark. It's going to be illegal hit by Chancellor, late hit after the end zone. And we'll see. It is against Chancellor. So I'm just going to have to go down and say, you got to lock the windows, shut the front doors, batten down the hatches because a storm warning's coming. Because it's a cyclone. Touchdown! Eli Harris in the end around.
46, 5:08 to play. And then a crucial point after, if you will, if you're looking for a continuously moving clock, because right now it's a 34-point lead, and this point after make it, if good, will make it a 35-point. Garrett Hutchinson doesn't miss often, but he missed his last attempt when hit the upright.
Got to make this to make it a running clock. So.
And, of course, the holder, Till Butler. Steve, your long snapper there. Jordan Dotson, is it number 99? There he goes. Kick is up, and he's back to being good. It's 41-6.
41.
Chargers in the end zone. Looks like some Chancellor players are getting into it. Looks like it's going to be forced on the kickoff.
We'll tell you that about this broadcast made possible by UVA Community Credit Union. Your financial success enables us to be a positive force in the Culpeper community. UVA Community Credit Union, 888-887-9136. And Abel Hegan Air, able to keep your family comfortable through every season. Abel Heating and Air at 718-7556. And I'll tell you what, Steve, for these guys who are up top tonight, whether it's Johnny behind the camera or the Eastern View and Chancellor coaching staffs, they'd probably all like to have a little bit of heat right about now, wouldn't they?
They would. Steve George, 27. Spotsylvania, 0.
So we were just listening to Dave Richardson announce some updates on the scores. And so an important game in action, King George and Spotsylvania, with King George having its way in that game.
I think Spotsylvania is still drunk from their hangover, or still having a winning hangover. Beating Eastern View last week, and they just probably came out flat, which is understandable. You get yourself up so much to stop Eastern View, and then King George was loaded. They wanted to win. They need to win to see to get in the playoffs, and they look like they're doing a convincing job down there at Spotsylvania.
But when you describe Spotsylvania's situation as perhaps being likened to some sort of sweet hangover, it made me think of that song we heard in the 70s. I got the sweetest hangover. I don't want to get over. You know what I'm talking about with Tom? Is that?
I know about the
I don't want to get over. Yeah, I don't know. It's a female singer, and we'd know the name if we heard it, but it's one of those blasts from the past. But you know, talking about Spotsylvania, sometimes, you know, it seems like it just sort of comes down to matchups and styles. Maybe Spotsylvania matched up in a way last week against Eastern View that worked well for them, but then against King George is a whole different team, different lineup, different formations, and maybe just not one that's compatible for them tonight.
Well, Spotsylvania knew win or lose, they're still in the playoffs, so,
yeah,
you know, who knows?
Well, what's this going to do you know, to Chancellor tonight? If Chancellor loses, Steve, they finish the regular season at 5-5. Where is that going to leave them
out
in this playoff hunt?
Could leave them out, depending on the Power 10, Power 10 and Huguenot game. If Power 10 wins, Huguenot is out. King George wins by getting in spots of beating Spotsylvania. I think Chancellor's on the outside looking in. They take the top eight teams. And I know the top six, so 7 and 8 are going to be up in the air.
Well, the quarterback there, Trevin Edwards, ran the ball on first down. He picked up 3 yards, 2nd and 7. Clock will continuously move here in this the rest of the game for as long as the Cyclones hold a 35-point or more differential, and there's no timeouts or
injuries,
right.
Now, we'll stop on change of possession. As far, you know, change of possession, we'll stop then.
3rd and 5 now, Chargers from their own 25-yard line. Trevin Edwards, the quarterback. Ziggy Carter behind him. And four receivers to the left, to the right. Pump fake. Edwards now rolls to his left, throws downfield. There's that arm I was telling you about. This one's caught at the 35-yard line. And here's a return man taking it all the way down inside the 10-yard line. Mm-hmm. That was the receiver, Bryson Edwards, on the play.
And Mark, if you saw the quarterback, Trevin Edwards just kind of motion for him to go deep. And you know, what happened was the defensive back for
came jumping up
and you know came to up to stop the run and just left him wide open.
Okay, so they now have the ball, it looks like, at the 9. Let's check the spot. Scoreboard says 4. I don't think that's right. You look at the field out there, Steve. Are you seeing it at the 4?
Yep,
yeah, maybe it is. Okay, it is at the 4. So Bryson Edwards hauled in the pass, and then yards after the catch here, Ziggy Carter gets it down to about the 1, and a penalty flag comes in late.
Yeah, but we'll see what the... Might be against Eastern, might be against Chancellor for a late hit, and it's going to be a...
Steve Shanks, Freddie Shanks, Dave Pollard, and Chris Settle. Our JV squad is David Rao, Will Ashwell.
It is going to be against Chancellor, Mark. That's going to be a personal foul right there.
Thank you all for your support.
The officials are telling him. Say, boys,
athletic program.
Clean it up. You can't have those late hits.
Here comes the call. The referee in the white hat. Dead ball foul against Chancellor.
So then when the ball's placed, the clock will start again. And again, this helps Eastern View keep that ball out of that end zone, 15-yarder.
Eastern View High School football team coaches would like to recognize and thank the 2019 football managers, Blake Lillard, Lauren Fling, and Isabella
Sanchez. There we go.
Back to the 14-yard line it is now. And it is... I think it's 1st and goal from that spot. First and goal,
but again, it's still backed up. Because it was a dead ball foul.
Even though you look at that down marker over there, they're showing 2nd down over there, Steve. But it was 1st and goal from the 4-yard line. And then the running back took it to the 1 where they had the penalty that pushed it back. So
dead ball foul.
All right, well, we're going to tell you on this timeout that this broadcast is made possible by Mama Mae's. Our new location on Sperryville Pike offers the same fresh pizza and subs. Always fresh, always good. Only Mama Mae's at 829-9200. 100. Well, 2 minutes and 46 seconds to play here in the third quarter. And it's Eastern View 41, Chancellor 6. Wow, let's talk about that big play that Trevin Edwards hooked up with Bryson Edwards on, Steve, because we were talking about how well Trevin Edwards looked in the pregame drills for this ability to throw that ball. And, you know, he came out in a situation where he obviously had to pass. And hooking up with Bryson Edwards, that was a huge gainer for Chancellor. Gave him a little bit of life.
It sure was.
But now they have the ball marked back to the 14-yard line, where the down marker says second down and the clock says first down. Here is a handoff to Carruthers, and a nice tackle by Alex Spangler drops him near the line of scrimmage.
Yep, so now it brings up, now it should, the down marker saying third down.
And now the clock is in, is on the same page. So it's third down and goal now from the 14.
So you got two chances here for Chancellor to try to get a score, but how big was that penalty?
I think very big now because it changes maybe what their calls are going to be here, because they had it first and goal from the 4, and now it's third and goal from the 14. And Trevin Edwards, of course, he's got a good arm, and he's a good ball carrier too. He rolls to his right and he throws. This one incomplete. He had a receiver out there, Blake Leak defending. But if he had thrown it in the right spot, it might have been a touchdown. Instead, an incomplete pass brings up fourth and goal from the 14. Now, if you want to stop it from being a contingency running clock, you could take a field goal here.
Yeah.
But it's not going to bring you back much into the game, is it?
No. That would be an insult to your own team by going out there and say, offense, we know we can't do it. Bring out the kicking team.
Yeah, no, but you got fourth and 14, too. You're asking your offense to get 14 yards here.
Well, you know they're going to have to throw it to the end zone to get the, you know. So if I was Eastern View, just stand at the end line, right to the goal line, say, all right, come on in.
All right, let's see what Edwards can do. He steps up. Here comes the pressure. They sack him for a loss. And that means a turnover on down, so they come away empty. And what does it mean also? That clock is going to keep running.
And Drew Sharina was on that tackle. We'll see. We'll hear what's a good little conference here. Is there a flag?
Just remind everybody if you need to get this.
Yeah, there is a flag down.
Call home,
might
call
be holding home. Against Chancellor.
That'll stop the clock, won't it?
The end of the quarter. Out of field four kicking contest by Sarah Hatfield for one.
But I hope it's not a personal foul. Give him first down.
Drew Sharina listening in here. Dead ball.
Yeah, it's a holding call.
Well, it's taken a while to sort it out. Remember last week how we were commenting that the officials were so assertive?
If there's a holding, just say the holding call and pick it and say who's it on.
Yeah.
They're going to wave it off, I think.
Holding.
Decline.
Holding, decline.
Okay. Wow, it took a long time to sort that out. But they decline it, and that means the turnover on downs, and Eastern View goes back on offense.
Why is the clock stopped? Because I know it's a penalty, but they should start it right on them. They set the ball. Now he's just
they got to reset it before they can restart it here. All right, so
let's give a big round of applause for our team doctor, Amari Gonzalez. Thank you, Dr.
Back on offense. And they have it marked at the 7-yard line. Minute 15 to play, third quarter action. 41-6, Eastern View. And of course, we mentioned this is the last game of the regular season. Next week will be the first round of the playoffs. And we're not really certain where Eastern View is going to stand. Likely a three seed. So they'll get the 6-seeded team. And right now that's Dinwiddie, right?
Right now it's Dinwiddie. It could be Patrick Henry of Ashland. It could be King George, depending on what teams lose.
Here's Lawson busting out of the pack in 30, 35, 40. Near sidelines, they force him out of bounds after he crossed midfield. Well, he took advantage of a nice opening there, and he just had daylight ahead of him. His longest run of the game.
It was the longest run of the game. He just took advantage. And I think Chancellor is now just worn out, Mark, and they're just going through the motions now. And, you know, of course, another score here will definitely cement the game's already cemented, but the clock continues to run here. Probably might just let it run out here to the fourth quarter.
And about 35 seconds and counting as Eastern View now has it on the Chancellor's side of midfield. Back to Lawson. There he goes, straight ahead. He's got a blocker with Spangler, and now Lawson takes it from 47 yards, unless there's a penalty flag down, and I don't see one.
No, there's not, Mark. And let's say, let's shut the windows, lock the front doors, and bend down the hatches. It's a storm warning. It's a cyclone touchdown. Brock Lawson from about 47 yards, and he just was stumbling and bumbling and rumbling all the way to the end zone.
Why did he make it look so easy? He had a couple of runs like this on this drive. It was like there was just daylight from the beginning.
Well, and also you got to give, you know, credit to the boys up front and the offensive line, but also Chancellor's defensive line is just worn out. I mean, they're just gassed.
It's 47-6. Garrett Hutchinson on for the point after. Till Butler, the holder, does a nice job of getting that one down. As the kick is no good, a rare miss. But I think there was a little bit of trouble there getting that ball down. Butler did a good job of corralling it, but just a little bit off is all it takes to be wide of the mark. So 47-6. Hutchinson's missed twice tonight, uncharacteristically. But 47-6, our score, with 19.4 seconds showing in this third quarter. There's a cheerleading unit, Steve, and you mentioned them earlier tonight. We were talking about, before the game started, the recognition provided to senior members of three different sports teams, football, cross country, and the cheerleading squad, all recognized here tonight. And some of the accolades that have come to the attention of Eastern View's cheerleading team.
That's true. They're going to the state championships. They're region champs. Now they're playing the Baby Shark song, made famous by the Nationals. Baby Shark. I know that because I got grandchildren.
I'm not familiar. I'm so out of the loop, aren't I?
Yep.
Here's Hutchinson's kick, fielded inside the 15-yard line. 20 out. This is Kim Carruthers, the return man, looking for a little more running room. They stop him after he crossed the 30-yard line. He got out to about the 35. Decent field position for Chancellor, but to use another old expression, too much, too little, too late.
Yeah. Too much, too little, too late.
And we've had a win.
Baby Shark is a nursery rhyme there for little kids. And,
no pressure, Sarah.
Geraldo Parra of the Washington Nationals made it when they started their big winning streak, started using that as a motivation for the team, and they just took it on from there. And it's been now a national phenomenon with the Norwich and Nats.
I sense you get pretty emotional when you sing that, too.
Baby Shark.
All right, here's Trevin Edwards, and this is Ziggy Carter, the ball carrier. He's going nowhere. Nowhere at all, and this is the way that third quarter has ended. With our score, Eastern View 47, Chancellor 6. We'll take a quick break and come back for the fourth and final quarter right after this.
Not everyone is an HVAC expert. Luckily, with 20 years of experience, Able Heating and Air can answer any and all questions you may have about your system. Peace of mind and knowledge that you've made the right choice, because they are able to keep your home comfortable. Able Heating and Air.
Battlefield Automotive is proud to continue support of our high school youth and the Culpeper community. Winner of the prestigious Ford President's Award for a record 13 consecutive years. Battlefield Automotive, a keystone of service and a cornerstone of our community.
CFC Farm and Home Center, hometown service since 1932. Finding the right outerwear for the job is difficult. Luckily, you'll find Carhartt Clothing, Red Wing, and Irish Setter Boots. From head to toe, it's easy to outfit with CFC Farm and Home Center. Found in Sons Funeral Chapels has made it their business to provide solutions during difficult times for over a quarter of a century. During that time, they've also made an investment in our youth through football, basketball, softball, baseball, lacrosse, and 4-H, among other projects. Good luck to tonight's teams, and do your best. Mama May's Pizza and Subs at our new location on 620 Sperryville Pike still serves you the best in pizza, subs, salads, and so much more. Always fresh, always good, only Mama May's. UVA Community Credit Union is a not-for-profit financial cooperative owned by individual members like you.
Your financial success enables us to offer better products and services to all of our members and to be a positive force in the Culpeper community.
All right, welcome back to our broadcast and to the start of the fourth and final quarter here at Cyclone Stadium as we open this quarter with Chancellor in possession, second and 10 at its own 36-yard line. Here is the delayed handoff to Carruthers. The ball carrier gets to the 40. He picked up 4 yards, and it's going to bring up third and six. And we have a contingency running clock here at this juncture because of the differential in the score, which is by 35 or more points. And we had a penalty flag, I believe, at the end of this play, Steve. They're sorting it out now.
Penalties will stop the clock. We'll see what the call is here.
Go, Silver Scales!
Officials take a long time, Mark. I agree with you. They take a long time to sort things out. It's like they're having coffee and tea out there.
When sports and luck against Chancellor, wow.
Well, Chancellor's probably, upset. They came in here with high hopes to try to be competitive and play for a playoff spot, and they just got their butts kicked. And then, understandably, they're upset.
Sure are.
So we're looking at, I'm looking at over here in the sideline number 46. Looks like he's going to take over the quarterback here in the second half. It's fourth quarter, but we don't have Caden Hughesby, number 16, is usually quarterback. I wonder if they just change numbers.
Good possibility. We'll try to find out as here's a quick throw near side to your receiver, Donovan Williams. He got out across the 40 out to about the 45. He's going to get back a lot of that lost yardage. And it's going to bring up
second and one.
Fourth and one.
Yeah, fourth and one here.
How did you get a lot of your yards back, didn't he, Mark?
He did, because the line of scrimmage was originally the 36, and they moved it to the 41, but then they got pushed back to the 26 on the penalty, and then on that play, picked up 19 of it. And here's Edwards. He's going to have a first down and much more. That was a nice play fake by Edwards. Pulled the defense. He had an opening over that left side, and he made the most of it. And that'll move the sticks for Chancellor. Of course, the clock will continue to run as well. They'll now mark it inside the Eastern View, or right at the Eastern View 40-yard line, rather. That's a pick of 15 yards by Trevin Edwards, the quarterback.
And he's deft with the ball. I mean, he's deft handling it. In other words, he's very deft and sleight of hand and very good there, back there in that position.
This is Edwards here. Scanning the field, now throwing over the middle. He's got a receiver caught. This one was caught by Donovan Williams. And making the tackle for Eastern View was number 18, Dylan White, one of the reserve players. He seems to be a little shaken up or a little slow to get to his feet.
I think he's more mad that he blew the coverage. That he was, hurt on it. But
marked it at the 16. That's a pickup of 24 right. yards on the play.
And showed off the arm of Edwards right back there in that quarterback position.
Well, we said he can throw it, no doubt. And it's first and 10, Chancellor, at the Eastern View 16-yard line. Ziggy Carter back there with him. Edwards again surveying the field. Has all kinds of time. Now he throws it for the end zone. This one is incomplete, and it was broken up. A couple of Cyclone defenders converged on the play, and they're both a little shaken up there. Tried to get the pass into Donovan and Williams, and a couple of Cyclones collided.
One is, looks like Blake Leake. His 18 is Dylan White.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Blake Leake's the other one. Maybe a blow if it was Leake. He might got the wind knocked out of him, Blake.
It was Spangler.
Number two, he gets up.
So it was Spangler and Dylan White. They both seem to be okay here. That'll be, when the play resumes, it'll be second down and 10 from the 16-yard line.
And they'll have to go off. One of them is going to have to go off. We'll see, because Blake Leake, they got Blake on the sideline because they're resting him. But
okay, this broadcast made possible by Able Heating and Air. Able to keep your family comfortable through every season. Able Heating and Air at 718-75-56. 9:23 to play, fourth quarter action, 47-6 Eastern View. Chancellor now has it Second down and 10 at the Eastern View 16-yard line. Trevin Edwards, the quarterback, number 19. Ziggy Carter, running back behind him. Edwards going to throw it to the end zone. Incomplete.
And I think we're going to have an interference on Culpeper. I mean, Eastern View. Keeping the Culpeper on the play right here in the end zone. Either that or holding. Let's see what the call is. Because it looked like they were face guarding him. Let's see what the call is.
He's thinking about it.
Thinking about it, getting ready to make the signal and what happened.
Yeah. Second thought.
Nope. No soup for you.
Well, what is it? Holding. Hey, oh, Chancellor. Holding. Offsetting then. There we go.
All right.
All right.
Second down.
All right. After all that, offsetting penalties. Replay it. Second down and 10 here at the 16-yard line. But clock continues to run. That's not a good thing for Chancellor. Although, even if it weren't a continuously running clock, the odds of coming back next to none as Edwards is in trouble. Reverses his direction and trips and falls with the credit to tackle belonging there to number 78 of Eastern View. And that's Elijah
Edwards
Hoskin.
Tackle by number seven.
Just tripped him up. That's all you needed to do. Clock continued to run.
5-10, 15, 17. He lost a yard. Brings up third and 11 here. See what Edwards dials up with Carter behind him. He's going to throw out there to the far side. Got a receiver. Tackled near that first down marker was Cody Moore.
See, did he get there or not? That's the thing.
I think he's a little shy.
And there's a flag.
Unsportsmanlike against Chancellor. And that's the second unsportsmanlike penalty against Chancellor.
That was against
Are they becoming a little unnerved? Huh?
Yeah, that was against 19, the quarterback. He was talking to the ref the whole time, and I think he said some unpleasant things to the ref. You can't do that, Mark. Because it was the ref was just walking right beside him. He just dropped the flag. And said, you know, unsportsmanlike. So he either said, you know, give us a break or whatever, and the ref didn't like it. So...
You're going the wrong way there.
Yep.
Yeah, there you go. To the rear march.
Yep. He's going up.
Fourth quarter,
no.
King George,
it says here.
34.
No, it's against.
Spotsylvania 6. Oh.
Started back there. Okay.
I think he had to start it from the point of the spot, right?
Oh, okay. Maybe from the spot. So it wasn't against quarterback. It was somebody downfield getting into a late hit or something against.
Now they've got it back to the 24.
So, Mark, trivia question. Can you name of any other team nicknamed the Chargers?
In Virginia.
Yep.
And the answer is yes, I can.
All right. Name one.
Chantilly.
Okay. There's another one.
Central.
You got
of Lunenburg.
Yep. Yeah. Old Ange. Barn got that one.
All right. Incomplete pass. And I believe this turns the ball over on downs to Eastern View. So I did pretty good with that one. So the trivia was, name some other schools in the Virginia High School League known with the mascot Chargers. And I came up first with Chantilly. You said, well, name another one. And I said Central of Lunenburg. Now, are there any others you can think of?
No, I've been trying to say that there is another nickname, the Crusaders, in the state of Virginia.
I think if you're going to hear Crusaders, you're probably talking about a private school.
No, I am, but they play in the public school VHSL football, and they're out of Lynchburg.
Oh, is it Liberty Christian?
Yep.
I didn't know they were the Crusaders.
I think they're the Crusaders.
They may be. Okay. I see them at the 4A level.
Yep.
Yeah. Liberty Christian. Yeah. I'll check into that. Okay.
Yep.
So here, now we're going to look for substitutions here as reserve players are in late in this game. So 46, as you mentioned, is not Doug Plank.
It's the phantom quarterback.
Unless Caden Huseby has changed numbers.
Let me find out if he has.
All right. And we're going to be picking up new numbers for you throughout because Eastern View has gone deep to its bench. Okay, so we're going to start getting some identification help here.
Ricky Butler is the quarterback, number 46.
All right, so 46 is Ricky Butler. Let's put him on our roster for future.
You got her player, but Ricky Butler is now quarterback.
Ricky Butler.
He was the other JV quarterback.
We got an injured Chancellor Charger. Number 13 at Chancellor is Braden Drugitz, the coach's son. He's assisted off the field and has a return to the action. Eastern View has it. Third and four, but it's on 30 with reserve players galore in on the scene here. Ricky Butler, the quarterback, throws near side as yet another penalty flag comes down.
Man, it's going to be roughing the passer against Chancellor on number 15. Jakari Struthers, who just pushed the quarterback down after he threw the ball. And this is going to be, again, frustration play. We're supposed to have a running clock, but it looks like it's being held up by penalties.
So let's pick up some of these new players, Steve. 52. We don't have him.
Rob Run, 28.
Don't have number 52 on this roster. 46, we said, was Ricky Butler. 24 is D'Artagnan Sherbin.
That are here today. And
let's see who else we can pick up here. We don't have the ball out to 45.
45 is Nicholas. Shoot.
Butler handing off. And this is to the running back number 40. And that would be Deuce Washington.
Deuce! Another flag. Another.
Whoa. This one might get ugly there.
Yeah, 66. Nate Newman involved. And they're going to. Yeah, the officials are going to start. You just got to tell the coaches, say, hey, look, boys.
Let's settle down.
Settle down. The officials will call the game right here. You don't want that.
All right, let me get the spot in. This broadcast made possible by UVA Community Credit Union. Your financial success enables us to be a positive force in the Culpeper community. UVA Community Credit Union, 888-887-9136. All right.
You see, the officials are taking way too long in this game.
Winter sports begin Monday. Check our website.
I mean, I know there was a scuffle there, but I mean, you know, you just said it right then. You say, boys, you get thrown out. You won't play the next game. See, it won't mean nothing to Chancellor.
They don't have a next game.
They don't have a next game. And so.
After all that,
the officials are coming over to Coach Hatfield. One of them is.
Dead ball, personal foul, Chancellor. Dead ball, personal foul, Eastern View.
First
personal foul.
And after all that, we're going to repeat it.
And we're going to do it all over again, Alex. Can you give me?
Looks like it's second and three now. Eastern View from the Chancellor 49-yard line. We are approaching the six-minute mark here of this fourth and final quarter. Deuce Washington runs into a host of Chancellor players.
You see, number eight is in there throwing punches.
And you're going to get a penalty flag coming in there. He looked like he was hitting a heavy bag.
Yeah, he was.
Cameron Hawkins,
he needs to be thrown out. He was throwing punches on that play.
And in his defense would be that he was trying to jar that ball loose by throwing punches in the direction of the ball rather than the player. But I don't think that that's going to stand.
No, he didn't. I mean, they might have to even throw him out. I mean, he was just out there just throwing punches at the ball.
Yeah, he was definitely throwing punches. It looked like it was like he would throw someone at a heavy back, Steve.
Yeah, he would. I mean,
he had pretty fast hands.
He did that. He did move pretty good. I mean, he's sitting there going.
I don't mean to make light of it.
Well, I was going to get, the officials have thrown him out. Because he tossed him right there.
Like to
I think we're going to have a timeout to see if these two teams can decide that cooler heads should prevail. All right, well, this broadcast is made possible by Mama May's. Our new location on Sperryville Pike offers the same fresh pizza and subs. always fresh, always good. Only Mama May's. 829-9200. We'll see, we're down to 5:54 to play, and Eastern Butte's going to get the big win here tonight. We'll get into the postseason next week. Likely play at home against Dinwiddie. Of course, that's subject to change.
Could be possibly three teams: Dinwiddie, Patrick Henry of Ashland, or possibly King George. Might, you know, just don't know yet. But all in all, it looks like the playoff scenario will be Louisa's beating Almar 45-0, but right now Crosby and Monacan are at 7-6 at halftime. Crosby's in Division 16.
I was going to say, yeah.
If Monacan beats them, they will go into first with a 9-1 first seed in the region. But here are the top six: is Louisa, Monacan, Eastern View, Spotsylvania, and the fifth seed was all right after this play.
Deuce Washington, nowhere to go as Chancellor's number 55, Adam Smith, makes the tack.
The fifth seed was Patrick Henry, and the sixth was Dinwiddie. The seventh was Huguenot, and the eighth was Chancellor. So, you know, it could end up being Dinwiddie. It could end up being Patrick Henry of Ashland. It could be a lot of teams.
So there's a lot of these reserve players in here tonight for Eastern View at this point. We mentioned number 46 is Ricky Butler, the quarterback. Deuce Washington on his left. And on the end of round, this is number 17, Greg Bradley. And Bradley's got a little running room out there. And Bradley will pick up first down yardage for Eastern View. And he went out of bounds. But the clock will continue to run. So I haven't really looked too deeply at a lot of the teams on the outside area, but let's say Patrick Henry of Ashland. We know they're coached by Ken Wakefield. What do you know about Patrick Henry as far as their talent level at this point?
I haven't really studied the market, which I could be, mm-hmm. you know, answer that question. You know they're going to be well coached with Coach Wakefield. They'll probably be good defensively. They're in with a 6-3 record, so I don't know who they're playing tonight. I think they might be playing Atlee. Or no, they're playing their annual against Lee Davis, so they should win that game. So
here's Eastern View with first down. After that big pickup, and the ball carry here is number 24, D'Artagnan Sherbin.
D'Artagnan, all for one and one for all. Can you name the rest of the three Musketeers?
I cannot.
Oh, I stumped old Mark.
You will get me on Musketeer trivia, no doubt.
Yeah, I don't know them either.
5-yard pickup by Deuce Washington.
I don't D'Artagnan. I know one.
Yeah. We will be hosting second and five, 3:32 to play here in the fourth quarter. 47-6 Eastern View. And the luxury of going deep to that bench and getting these reserve players some necessary playing time. And on the handoff, it was a faulty exchange. As Butler tried to get it to Deuce Washington, he fumbled. And Smith, the other linebacker, Adam Smith, who's had a pretty good game for Chancellor tonight, recovers it, gives the ball back to his teammates with 3:15 to play here in this final quarter.
And now Chancellor's going to take over. And the penalty and the clock will stop or start as soon as the ball is set. And then I know Eastern View just wants to get out of here with a – looks like they've rebounded very well against a loss against Spotsylvania.
See, this is a game where we've seen personal fouls assessed against both teams, and actually Chancellor may be leading in that department.
I think they are, Mark. You're right.
I mean, I think part of that has been just the really high degree of frustration and on their part.
And I don't know why Chancellor keeps calling timeout. So
they want to make a miracle comeback and win this thing.
I guess so. They want. It's freezing. Oh me! But yeah, it's going. We're gonna have a game here next week. Like I said, it'd be interesting if it was Dinwiddie. That means, you know, for third year in a row, we'd have Dinwiddie in the playoffs. But we're gonna face them in the second round. Last year, we beat them for the regional championship down at Huguenot High School. I remember that was a cold day.
All right, let's do a trivia time. Let's see if we can stump Petey. What is the mascot for Dinwiddie, and what other teams you could think of Sheridan?
Dinwiddie Generals.
Right.
So you have Washington Lee.
Up in Arlington.
And Washington W.L. Lee in Montrose are the Eagles.
So they're the Eagles, but Washington Lee of Arlington, they're the Generals, as you know. Well, we got some reserves in for Chancellor as well. And the quarterback now is Isaiah Monegut, number 6. And the clock will run 2:45 and counting.
What I was going to ask you another trivia question. High school football and mascots, what are the leading team? How many teams are named the Eagles, and how many teams are nicknamed the Knights?
So in the Eagles, I'm going to say 900.
900.
Of the 700 schools? Yeah, that was. I think the last count was, what, 18?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, but it seems like more like 36.
Well, you got Tigers is a big nickname, too.
I think probably after Eagles, maybe the most is Panthers, if I'm not mistaken.
It would be the Knights, would it?
I don't know. I mean, there are a few schools known as the Knights. I mean, well, we could have some fun naming them.
I'm trying to think, whose nickname is the Panthers?
Well, you got Massaponics. You've got Rappahannock, for example. You've got, who else? Northwood. Mm-hmm. That's three right there. Panthers, you said Massaponics. I'm sure some others will come to mind.
Yeah, I don't know the beach school's nicknames too well.
Maybe there are a lot of schools that are known as the Cougars, too.
That's true.
I mean, we could name a bunch of those. This is your reserve quarterback here, number 6, and that's Isaiah Manigat.
How many nicknames of the Cavaliers? I know one's in our district.
Well, that's Caroline. I was thinking about them the other day. So how about Lord Botetourt? That's one.
Princess Anne in Virginia Beach.
King William.
Yep.
That's one. Here's another one. Chatham. Yeah. A lot of Cavaliers, right?
Yep.
Eight teams known as the Blue Devils, right?
We know that. And you got the Patriots. Mm-hmm. A lot of teams named the Patriots.
Well, I think of Park View and Albemarle. Who else are you thinking of?
Well, you got Patrick Henry.
That's right. Well, and you've got Patrick Henry of Roanoke or the Patriots. Patrick Henry of Ashland of the Patriots.
Patriots, yeah. Yeah. Then there's new schools that have opened up in Northern Virginia, Independence and Rock Ridge. Riverside, what are their nicknames?
Well, Riverside's the Ram and Rock Ridge is the Phoenix. What's the other school you just mentioned?
Independence.
I'm not familiar with them.
They just opened this year.
I'm going to guess Loudoun County?
Yep.
Well, you're opening a high school every year.
I know.
Final 20 seconds ticking off on this fourth and final segment tonight.
John Champ, what are their nicknames?
They are the Knights.
Knights, okay.
And you were mentioning there were a lot of schools known as the Knights. Yeah. You got Buckingham and Spotsylvania and James River of Buchanan and Cave Spring. Oh, you go. Final seconds ticking off. And this is it. So your final score at Cyclone Stadium, Eastern View 47 and Chancellor 6. Steve, Johnny's up behind the camera freezing.
Yeah, but
let's make this brief. 47-6, our final score. Final thoughts as we wrap up this regular season and look into next week's first round of the playoffs.
Well, looking next week, there'll be a home game here of Eastern View next week, starting at 7 o'clock mark, opponent to be named. And Eastern View has acquitted itself after that loss last week against Pennsylvania with a big win tonight against Chancellor.
All right, way to call it. Okay, once again, our final score from Cyclone Stadium, Eastern View 47, Chancellor 6. For Johnny and Steve, I'm Mark O'Connell saying thanks for watching and supporting Cyclones football on the Culpeper Media Network. Have a great weekend, everybody, and we will see you next week in the first round of the playoffs at a time and against an opponent to be named. So long.